is the last day to submit your yearbook photo online. Mr. Keebler needs to do it. You're not alone. Reach out to Ms. Stern with any questions. Reminder, dine and donate at Mother Clucker's on Monday, January 25th. Mention CICS for 20% of sales to be donated. Wow. And then the K-4 curriculum pickup was this week. Make sure you go to school early next week if you weren't able to this week. This curriculum is required for Q3 learning. So make sure you get to school and pick it up. Great. All right. Let's get into our Pride Points competition. Coming in fifth place, Ms. Cullen Revel's class. In fourth place, Ms. Kamen's class. In third place, Ms. Slabowski Wong's class. And in second place, Ms. Meyer's class. And this week's winner with 553 Pride Points last week, the one, the only, Mr. Malone's class. Hopefully you can hear this, guys. Woo!
They can hear you. Great job, guys.
Woo! Oh, guys. Way to go. Okay. I hesitate to move to the next slide. It's riddle time, everybody.
Okay, I can't get past this slide. There we go.
Oh, it's the animation. Look at that. Who is that guy? It's crazy. What has to be broken before you use it? What has to be broken before you use it? Here we go. All right. Let's get into everybody's favorite part of the community gathering, Pumas of the Week. All right, first out of the gate. This Puma has been working incredibly hard to complete her schoolwork. She is present, participating, and eager to learn. We are so proud of your growth and want you to continue being the amazing Puma you are. Coming out of Ms. Drury's class with love, the Puma of the Week is... Oh, something's moving. Here we go. Jasmine C. Way to go. Way to go, Jasmine. We go on to the next one, Miss Kamen's Puma of the Week. This week, it's a special one. This week, our whole class is deserving of Puma of the Week. Students worked hard with Miss Mark while Miss Kamen was out Wednesday and made sure she didn't skip a beat. Miss Kamen loves seeing everyone becoming better friends and working hard to become smarter each day. Here we go, coming out of Miss Kamen's class. The entire class! Way to go! Woohoo! Good work, everybody!
Good work.
All right. Here we go. On to the next one. Coming out of Ms. Cobiella's class, this Puma has really stepped it up this week. He has been working hard to stay focused throughout the day. His effort has not gone unnoticed and shines through on his independent work. Keep it up. Coming out of Ms. Cobiella's kindergarten community, the Puma of the Week is Mason L. Way to go, Mason! Woohoo! All right, it's time for the answer to our riddle. Let's check the chat and see what people came up with. Here we go. What has to be broken before you can use it? Oh yeah, why wouldn't we use that picture for the yearbook? It's very indicative of what this year has been for me, right? Wow, we have a lot of students that are nailing this one. Olivia from Miss Meyer's class, Miss Cullen Revel's class, Mr. Sheets's class, Nurse Jay got it, Miss Aglesky, Mona and Noah from Miss Guyon's class. Mr. Sloan just put an emoji in that could be considered a correct answer. Third grade says what the given answer, and I'll say another correct answer. A puzzle has to be broken before you can use it. Yeah. Miss Mobley says, a sick beat? Yeah. Sure. Campbell guessed egg. Great. Ooh, Miss Hardy said coconuts in soup. Oh, and the correct answer is egg, by the way. Ooh, or the given answer. JDL has another good one. Glow stick. Glow sticks have to be broken before you can use them too. Definitely. Nice. I like coconuts as well. Let's see. Just scrolling back through to make sure I did not miss anyone. All right. Here we go. On to the next riddle. What travels around the world but stays in one spot? What travels around the world but stays in one spot? Ooh, Irving said chopsticks for the last one. That's an interesting answer too. Cool. All right, on to Miss Aglesky and Miss Eden's Puma of the Week. Here we go. All right. This Puma did wonderful work this week. He came to class on time, completed all of his seesaw activities, and participated in class by sharing great ideas. We love having him be a part of our first grade community. Keep up the great work. Coming out of Miss Aglesky and Miss Eden's first grade community, the Puma of the Week is Isaiah. Hey!
Woo! Hey, Isaiah! Congratulations!
All right, on to Miss Geckle's Puma of the Week. This Puma has been working so hard this week. We love him. We love hearing them share during class. They're always so kind to their classmates. Thanks for being you. We love you. Coming out of Miss Geckle's first grade community, the Puma of the Week is Jaden L. Woo-hoo! Way to go! All right, here we go. On to Miss Guyon and Mr. Staten's Puma of the Week. This math superstar has already solved 70 puzzles on ST Math this week. We have noticed how hard he works each day and how he always does his work. We're so thankful to have such a wonderful listener in class. Way to go. Coming out of Miss Guyon and Mr. Staten's second grade community, the Puma of the Week is my birthday buddy, Lucas S. Woo-hoo! Way to go, Lucas. All right. Just a hot jam. We're going to keep going with that one on our next Puma of the Week. I guarantee that. This Puma is really hitting their stride. They've shown so much determination this year, and the growth is obvious in their work. Not only do they work hard, but they bring so much positive energy to our classroom. Thanks for being you. Coming out of Mr. Sheets' second grade community, the Puma of the Week is April E. Way to go, April. Here we go. What travels around the world but stays in one spot? Let's see what the chat has to say, because I have a feeling we have a lot of correct answers that may not be a given answer. Let's see. Oh, wow, we have a lot of correct answers. Okay, here we go. The sun kind of stays in one spot and we rotate. Although I think that the sun may be moving through the universe, but I love that answer. A couple people gave it. Ms. Zagleski's class, fourth grade, Mr. Malone, and Ms. Hardy, their class said sun. Ms. Mobley said the internet. Yeah, could be. Let's see. Abigail says air from Mr. Sheets's class. The moon rotates around the earth. So that one may not be quite as correct. Let's see. A lot of second graders have the given answer. A lot of second graders say the sun, which we've said is not the given answer, but could be correct for sure. Third grade says the sun. They also have the given answer. Callie from Ms. Hardy's class has the given answer. Jaden says a plane or a jet. So does Tyler. Well, they do travel around the world, but they're not necessarily staying in one spot. Well, hopefully they're staying in the air, right? Miss Nurse Jace's sun or moon. Miss Geckel, Bobby and Aaron say water. I think water moves a little bit because of gravity. Mattingly says a clock, could be. But a lot of people, wow. Valeria says a hamster because it can travel in its cage but stay in one spot, which is very close to the given answer, which is a postage stamp. Let's see who all had it, because a lot of people had it. Callie from Miss Hardy's class, third grade Miss Lebowski Wong's class said postage stamp. Elijah and Yesha from Miss Myers' class say stamp or letter. Exactly. Emmy from Miss Myers' class says postage stamp. Yep. All great answers. I love these ones that are so open that we can like figure out other things that aren't the given answer that are also correct. What a great, what great creativity. Here we go. What word is spelled wrong in the dictionary? What word is spelled wrong in the dictionary? Here we go. Think on it. And on to Miss Cullen Revels, Puma of the Week. This puma is kind to everyone. They're persistent and responsible even when it isn't easy. Their determination and positive attitude make them stand out. Coming out of Miss Cullen Revels, third grade community, the Puma of the Week is Axel C. Way to go, Axel. Nice work. Shoes on, get up in the morning, grab a mirror, rock and roll. Kink out, kick the drum, running on like a Rolling Stone. Sing song. All right, here we go. On to the next one. Hopefully I don't choke. Here we go. We are so lucky to have this student in our community. His classmates nominated them for being an awesome participant during class. They share their ideas. They're a good listener. And they're helpful towards others. Thank you for being you. Coming out of Ms. Slavowski Wong's third grade community, the Puma of the Week is Ilias M. Way to go!
Way to go,
Elias. Excuse me. Way to go, Elias. Right, here we go. On to Miss Myers' Puma of the Week. This Puma is working so hard this week, and his classmates have noticed his incredible drive. They nominated him for participating in class every day, taking initiative in his small groups, being a good friend, and always completing his activities on time. Keep up the amazing work. Coming out of Miss Myers' fourth grade community, the Puma of the Week is Matthew G. Way to go, Matthew. All right, on to the next one. This Puma was chosen for this week's Puma of the Week because she is so kind and because she works so hard. Mr. Malone also appreciates that she keeps trying even when she's experiencing really frustrating tech issues. You're amazing and we love you. Coming out of Mr. Malone's fourth grade community, the Puma of the Week is Juliana M. Here we go. Way to go, Juliana. All right. Let's see who's got the answer to this riddle. Here we go. What word is spelled wrong in the dictionary? Ooh, Miss Mobley has a given answer. Miss Hardy has the given answer. The fourth grade has a consensus. Miss Meyer, wonderful creativity on the spelling of your answer. Jaden, Carlise, Ryan, Carter, Andrea from Miss Guyon's class, Andrea from Miss Guyon's class, second grade, Mr. Sheets's class, Nurse Jay, Miss Lebowski Wong's class, Javier from Miss Cobiella's class, and Miss Cullen Revel's class all have the given answer, which is wrong. Wrong is spelled wrong in the dictionary, right? There we go. All right, on to the next riddle. What becomes wetter the more it dries? Ooh, this one might be a repeat. I think we might have had this one. What becomes wetter the more that the more it dries? What becomes wetter the more it dries? Here we go. All right, on to the art star of the week, our enrichment stars of the week. This Puma did an amazing job drawing her, making her drawing her own. She was extremely engaged in class this week, asked a lot of questions, and shared her ideas. Keep up the great work. Coming out of Miss Aglesky's class, the art star of the week is Stephanie M.
Way to go. Yay, Stephanie. Congratulations.
Woo-hoo. All right. The Makerspace star of the week. Hey, feeling good. Here we go. This Puma was the ultimate problem solver this week during our challenges this week. And Ms. Stern is so impressed with his ability to role model how to keep going when things don't go as planned. Coming out of Ms. Lebowski Wong's class, the Makerspace star of the week is Alexander K. Way to go, Alexander! On to the music star of the week. This Puma was so engaged this week. He was so helpful, always offering to share and even explain the difference between a crayon and pencil to a classmate. His teacher loves, or Mr. C loves, how practiced and positive he is. Here he is, this week's music star of the week, coming out of Miss Kamen's class, Elijah C. Way to go, Elijah! Some days you wake up and nothing Woo-hoo. Works, you feel surrounded. Gotta All give your right. feet some gravity to get you burned. This Puma works really hard and models a great example to his classmates of how to work out to be healthy. They're an awesome role model. You rock. Our PE star of the week from Miss Meyer's class is the one, the only, Jose Bravo! Way to go, Jose!
It's okay. It's okay. You're feeling good.
Congrats to all our enrichment stars. All right. Here we go. Time for the answer to our riddle. What becomes wetter as it dries? Let's check the chat. Let's see. Miss Mobley says an umbrella, not the given answer, but I think could be correct. Let's see. Miss Drury's class says ice. Interesting. Sand. From Miss Hardy's class is an interesting one. Fish from Miss Kamen's class is an interesting one. Nurse Jay says ice. Let's see. A lot of the given answer. JDL from Miss Cullen Revel's class says a napkin. Mud or a dog's nose from Miss Lebowski Wong's class. Interesting answers. But the given answer, Nurse Jay got Finn and Alec from Miss Cullen Revels class, Miss Lebowski Wong's class, Esmerai, Cassandra, Elise, Alex, and Noah from Miss Guyon's class, Miss Kamen's class, Miss Hardy's fourth grade class, Amaya, Frank, and Julian from Mr. Sheets's class, Jaden and Elijah from Miss Meyer's class all said towel. The more it dries, the wetter it gets. Absolutely. Woohoo! Way to go, guys. That was a tricky one. All right, it is time for everybody's second most favorite part of the community gathering, Staff of the Week. Here we go. This teacher is a super innovator. They're constantly thinking through how to provide students with opportunities to dig deeply and to become self-motivated, curious learners who make active decisions about their own learning. They thrive on collaboration and on hearing others' feedback. They're also a curious learner and always willing to try new things in search of what is going to be best for students. They're also humble and a fun colleague who leads through example. Their co-teachers are very privileged to get to work with them every single day. Here he is, this week's Staff of the Week, Mr. Malone! Woo! Way to go, Mr. Malone! Woo! I turned the volume down! Woo! Nice work! Yep, Nathaniel's right. I remember that riddle. He posted that we already had it, but that's all right. We've gone through a lot of riddles, and believe me, I was surprised that there were this many riddles out there. So we might get some repeats, but hey, it's going to keep you on your toes and remind you of the thinking that you had to do to solve it the first time. So hey, congratulations to Mr. Malone. Well deserved. Thank you all for being here. And joining us today for our community gathering. We are so happy to have you along with us. Keep working hard. Keep trying your best. Keep getting a little bit better every single day. We see you. We appreciate you. We love you. And as always, if you're proud to be a Puma, let me hear you say, Puma Pride! Have a fantastic Friday.